Kan du ge mig en ärlig och gillande för applåd? Wow! Says that arguments are really good to find out our imperfections and we can make it perfection. And that way we can become a better person. When someone make an argument to you, it is easy to defend or you can put blame back onto the person. But if you can use simple technique of communication and put some effort from your side, you can definitely make this argument to a positive discussion. In that manner, today I am going to take you through a journey of diffusing verbal criticism. During verbal criticisms, normally we people use four types of response. Let us see what are the types of response that we do when someone criticizes us. The first thing is withdrawing. When a person criticizes you, sometimes you may accept the criticism and withdraw without uttering a single word. Sometimes you may leave the hall, but the result is that you may lose your self-respect or self-esteem because you didn't stand on your ground and defend yourself. The second type of responding is rationalizing. In this method, you will admit the merit of the criticism and then you will try to explain why did you behave in that manner or why you use that word that led to a criticism or argument. In this type of criticism, the other party finds time, enough time, when you try to explain why you did in so and so manner that raised for a criticism or argument. The third type of response is counterattacking. Most of us know what is counterattacking. We turn the negative attention and fault from our side to the criticizer and try to prove that he is wrong. Doing so, the arguments only escalate and we avoid to find a real solution for the problem. And the finally is responding non-defensively. In this method, we listen to the person who shout on us very calmly with open minded. Try to understand his feelings behind his shouting. Once you find out the feelings behind his criticism, it is easy to open up the reason behind his criticism and then you can try to resolve by discussing with him. Out of these four types of responding, the responding non-defensively is the most important and productive one. Now, let us quickly go through what are the ways, what are the steps that we need to respond non-defensively. The first thing is listen. When someone shouts upon you, there will be many feelings hidden behind his words, more than the feelings will be hidden behind the words that he spoke to you. Try to find out that feelings by asking many questions. Once he opens up his feelings, it is easy to find out the reason behind his criticism, and then we can try to resolve the problem. The second thing is acknowledge. Just show an indication to this person that you acknowledge his criticism. But acknowledging the criticism doesn't mean that you accept whatever he said. Just we are only trying to consider his feelings or his problem has some value. By doing so, the speaker may reduce his anger while he is speaking to you. The other one is ask questions. Try to ask as many questions as possible to find out is there more than one reason behind his criticism or shouting to us. Other is paraphrase. Try to explain in your own words what the other person is feeling or reflecting. For example, if a husband and wife is quarreling, maybe husband forget to greet his wife for the anniversary and wife is not saying it directly and only shouting at the husband. So in this step of paraphrase, you can say, I must have forgotten to pay the electricity bill. So sometimes the wife will not respond, because that is true. Sometimes you will say, you can say that I forgot to pay money for our school, our kids' school education. So sometimes the wife will not react, because that is true. So in that way, try to bring out many things that the other person have in their mind. This is called paraphrase. And at last, agree with the truth. If there is a merit in that argument, if you are wrong, try to agree. Because if you deny the truth, that will definitely lead to more arguments. Once you follow these steps, you will reach at a position where you can find out the reason behind of their shouting or criticism. So just keep in mind, when you go to diffuse a criticism, remain calm, give more time to listen and try to understand the feelings of the other person. Don't take anything personally because he is affected more than us. Show non-verbal listening skills, like just bow in front of him that we are listening to him, or just nod your head. That way, just show him that we are listening to him, and at last show respect to the person who is shouting, because if you are not listening to him, he will increase his voice or he will shout more on us. So in this way, if you can follow all these steps of responding non-defensively, one day definitely you can convert the criticism to positive discussion. That's all from my presentation area. Now I'll be